Here we go. Hey, we're at Hannah's dinner. Hannah's down there. Hannah? Hey. Oh, yeah.
All right, I'm going to spare you guys. I have 10 stories. I won't tell one.
Okay.
And then we have a little program for everybody. The story I'm going to pick about Hannah, and I wrote it down so I wouldn't forget. Before I tell that, I want to thank all the out-of-town guests for coming, making the effort. I know it's a big deal, and it's important for them. Laurie's mom, Lucy, didn't get to come, but she's helping us out with dinner tonight, so she's here in spirit. And we didn't host Lucy. Cheers. She's got a lot of good stories. When she was little, I was taking her to a birthday party. And on the drive up there, she had a certain, I think she was maybe 7 or 8 years old only. About the same age as Sophia. She listened to the same song on the drive up there over and over and over again. So like on the fifth time, the CD had like 15 songs on it. And she kept playing song number 8. So I was working a lot. I was trying to be patient with her, influence and listen to that. I was spending quality time with Hannah, whatever. I'll just listen to the song. But after about the fifth one, I finally lost it. And I said, no, do not listen to that song again. So she sat there real quiet and says, okay, I can't listen to song number 8. Can I listen to song number 14? I said, I don't really care. As long as you don't listen to song number 8, I don't care what you listen to. So she punches the button, and the same song came on. Because I'm drunk, I had to give her a high five. That's the Dunlap side coming out of her. She pranked me really well. Before I go any further, does anybody else want to tell a little fun story about the piano that they experienced? If not, we can do it after this little recording. Sophia, do you have anything for that? Did she babysit you and leave you alone and not?
I don't know because I was too young to remember.
Oh, okay. Another one real quick was when she was pretty gutsy. She told her brother to get off the couch and he was watching television and he got up and got out of the way. We couldn't believe it.
She was 3 and he was 16. And she said, go off my couch.
He got up.
And she laid down on the couch and she tried to stretch herself out as long as she could.
Like
he did, because he took up the whole couch. And she put all the pillows down so there wouldn't be any room.
You remember that, Mark? I kind of did, actually. I'll never forget. One of the books that Hannah used to read when she was really little was called Are You My Mother? And she couldn't read it, but she had it memorized when I was reading it to her. So when you turn the page to, we had someone come over to the house to visit that hadn't seen it, you could turn the page and she would say the words on the page, but she couldn't read it. It looked like she could read it. And I made a little note of myself that she turned into that little bird turned into amazing RHS people.
Good one.
Like that? Yeah. So, the other thing I'm really proud of her about, she went to Schofield in the fourth grade. And one of the traits that I really liked about her was that one of the kids at the school was being excluded, one of the little girls was being excluded from the group. And Hannah always made an effort to sit with her at lunch and include her in all the stuff. And we think that's a really good trait to have. Fast forward, 2 weeks ago, she got an award from the high school that y'all may or may not know about. It was voted on by who, Clark?
The teachers and the staff at Richardson High School vote on one senior boy and one senior girl for this award. And it's a good citizenship award, and Hannah was voted on out of a class of 580 to receive the award for good citizenship for patriotism, service, leadership, and dependability.
It's called the Daughters. What's it called now? It's called the Daughters of the American Revolution Bronze Medal.
We were hoping it was a big scholarship money thing.
Making America great again.
That was really cool.
Yeah, I don't think they are. I don't think they're those people.
Okay.
I'm not the same.
If it was Matthew McConaughey, let's make America real. All right again.
Especially that high school. There were very few front voters.
Okay.
Lori, come on. You have a story? Any of these reminding you of like
time? So I'll start crying.
Well, I will tell you this before I lead into the other. Nancy and Don were at the hospital when you were born. Took you 16 hours, I think. And I know Morton was there. I think Lucy was there. It's kind of a blur. But they've been here from the very beginning. And they're here now.
It was a long day.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
She came out and I guess she was tired or something and she couldn't breathe and had to take her to the ER. So she was in the ER for...
She was in NEO for a little bit.
Yeah, and we had good insurance at the time. And it was an expensive bill and it got all completely covered by the insurance. Thank goodness. Now, if we hadn't had it, we might be able to decide.
You spent seven days in the rancher.
Yep. Charlton? You didn't remember anything? Mark?
I think we talked about it all at the house.
We did this again. You probably want to hear it. Mark wrote a story about her and got in college with it. So.
I'm really not that bad of a guy. I have a sister I love. That's how I got me. She went to the couch and gave it to her.
Anyway. Parents always want to say how great kid is, and in your case, it's true. Why not? Parents get to take some of the credit. I know you're doing well because of me, and in some cases, in spite of me. I'm sorry for all those things I might have made worse when attentions were there. I can't rewind time. I bet anybody, but you're going to continue to do well. You're very resilient. You'll be able to handle the challenges. There's an old saying, what's mine is yours, and what's yours is yours. And I'm yours, always. Yeah.
Favorite singer here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
What is?
Oh, my.
Here we
go. She's got a smile that it seems to me reminds
of childhood memories, where everything was fresh as the bright blue sky. Now and then when I see her face, she takes me away to that special place. And if I'd stare too long, I'd probably break down and cry.
I'm singing this. Here for
part.
Oh yeah, yeah.